everyone, what's up? It is Emperor Pro here, and welcome back to another episode of the Arbitrary Maker VXA Tutorials. This tutorial is going to be covering how to actually make a legitimate boss. Not just some powerful enemy, it kind of is just a powerful enemy, but anyway, basically it shows you how to set up the collapse effect and all that as well. So, go to Change Maximum in your database, in your Enemies tab here. You can access the database by clicking this little icon here. And, so let's go ahead and do that. Now, go to the Enemies tab, and let's click on Change Maximum. Increase it by 1. I already did. So it's 31 for me, so you should have a blank space down here. And we're going to name the enemy something creative. Cactus. That is very creative. Let's give it about... let's see. How much HP should we give it? Let's give it about 10,000 health. And about 99 MP. Attack? Let's do 450. Defense, 300. What was the default? I guess we'll never know now. Defense, 300. Magic attack, 250. Let's have it be definitely not 2,501. Let's have it be a more physical-based enemy. So, magic defense, potato. No. Magic defense, let's do about 250 as well. Agility, 250. Luck, 10. Now, here's the thing. You want to go over here, right-click right here, click edit, or just double-click. It's up to you. And go to the other tab. Then we're going to do collapse effect. We're going to select boss. And that's literally all you have to do. Now the enemy's going to collapse as a little bit differently than the other enemies will. But, it's going to be pretty cool. Now, the cactus will be... let's see. What can the cactus be? Oh, no. That looks like a cactus, kind of. that was really stupid. Huh. You know, I've never seen that. I mean, must see a new one. They must have added that in an update or something. I've never seen that. Did I spell it right? Minotaur? M-I-N-O. Oh, okay. M-I-N-O-T-A-U-R. Alright, so there we go. We have our Minotaur. EXP. Let's give him 5,000. And 250 gold. So half of that. So, his attacks. Let's set up some here. You can do that by double-clicking here. By the way, if you're wondering how to change the graphic, just double-click it. Just double-click a lot of things in this, and you will get far. Pretty much. Let's see. Minotaurs would have a lot of physical-based attacks, so... Let's see. Strong attack. Rating 5. Let's see. What else should he have? That's what he should have here. Provoke, maybe? But no, it wouldn't make much sense. Cleave. Oh, this is perfect, man. Berserker's Roar. You can continue to set up stuff here, which, if you want to, I'm going to as well. I'm just going to keep giving them random things, or you can give them your own set of skills if you wanted to do that. Berserker's Dance. Giant's Rampage. That's perfect, man. And he's not a Pokemon, so he's not going to use Tackle. I know this is a huge amount of skills, but it keeps things interesting at least. Here we go. So yeah, he has Strong Attack. Well, okay, let's see. He has Regular Attack, Strong Attack, Cleave, Berserker's Roar, Berserker's Dance, and Giant Rampage. Should we give him an Elemental Weakness? That is a good question. I don't know. Well, he's not a playable character, so we're obviously not going to give him that. We can actually have him Absorb, but I don't think I want to do that. Alright, let's just keep them like that, and we're going to click Apply, and we're going to test this out. So we're going to go to Troops, and we are going to go to Change Maximum, increase it by 1. So we have 31, and let's see, Minotaur, Add You, click Auto Name, and there you go. Let's change the battle back here. Make it look really epic. Dark Space. Why not? That's the most logical thing I've seen all day. Okay, he's a cactus, so obviously he likes deserts. Desert port things. Why not? Oh! Why not? A sand ship. Okay. Many of you guys would probably get annoyed about this. You know, I've gotten a lot of comments saying, like, oh, you should edit your stuff. And you know what? I realize that just messing around like this is really what you guys are mostly watching for anyway. I mean, you're learning something, and plus I'm just being stupid, as usual. I thought I seen it. There we go, desert. We'll just keep it a desert. Let's change the music, though. I want to make it something epic. So go to the system and change your battle music for a minute. Yeah, that's cool. We'll go with that one. Here we go. Back to troops. Battle test. I'm gonna make myself level 99. I'll be screwed otherwise. Yes, I'll use, like, the maximum equipment here. I'm gonna murk him, man. It'd be, like, one hit, one shot, man. Dragon armor, talisman of light. Oh, look at this. It's so... Oh, that might not be the best, strongest thing. That probably would, but it doesn't matter. Woo! I almost hit it initialize. That would have sucked. All right, let's do this. Minotaur has escaped from... Ah, I have your attack. What now? 16 damage. Oh, he's way too strong. Never mind. Now see, he's for maximum level, this is a pretty darn good boss. As you can tell, he's not exactly easy, but yet he's not really too hard either, as long as you have healing items. And I think that's really what... I think that's how boss battles should be, honestly. Like, make them not to where you can just keep on hammering attack and just win. I mean, you know, give the user a reason to use his healing items, and this would be one of them. He has a really strong attack, but then again, with a bunch of party members, he would be pretty weak on the max level. I chose max level because we only have one character at the moment. I could have set up more. We'll try that as well. And he's almost defeated. I swear this is actually a pretty cool boss battle. Use full potion. So yeah, this is probably a mid-game level to end-game level boss. Nothing really too major. Because I do have the ultimate equipment, and I'm not doing that much damage to him. But there he goes. And that right there is how you make a boss. I love that freaking collapse thing. That's really cool. Okay. Now, let's see. We're going to add some party members here, like Ernest. He's going to have... let's actually not do the max level. Let's do about level 50. But we're going to have four party members. See how that works. That was weird. We're not going to have maximum equipment either. I'm going to give him the Mithril Axe. Mithrils. I'm just going to give him, like, I'm just going to give him some, let's say he did have access to Mithril-based equipment and stuff. Lucky Charm. Those things are so tasty. Depending. I'm just going to give him, like, a bunch of random stuff here. Let's see. We need a mage. I think. Who's the mage here? Okay, Terrence is not the mage. Ryoma is not the mage. Ernest, are you the mage? No, you're not. Brenda? No. Rick? No. Alice? Maybe. No. Ah, what? Isabel, you mage? Yay! Isabel mage! Okay, see a fur hat, mithril rod, wait, magic staff, she's a mage, we'll give her something physical for the moment, silk cloaked, what, holy symbol, level 50, and last but not least, let's see what Noah has. Okay, cool, Noah's also a mage. I just want to kind of mix up the abilities and stuff. And actually rely on those as if this were a real battle. Alright, let's try it out, guys. Here we go. Really cool boss fight, actually. I love this. Now we're much lower level. We're going to be doing a whole lot less. So we got to really use our attack. It's based off user's attack. Okay, cool. That's interesting. So, let's see. Let's try a burst on him. That sounded very disgusting. It's our nuclear. Woo! What's going on? Oh, I took no damage. 145 damage. Nuclear. Okay. He's a little bit too powerful for level 50. So what we need to do is we need to do... So yeah, this is probably an end-game boss battle. You know, like, this enemy's definitely designed for end-game. You can always, you know, weaken him and stuff, obviously, but I had it set for... Why can't I use... Oh, TP, that requires TP for that one. Let's see... Tornado. Flame. Fire. That does nothing. There we go! You knew it, Isabelle! I don't know what she did, but... I forgot what I used on Isabelle, actually. Ooh, that's actually a very good spell to use against him. Okay, Isabelle used that flame, though? Oh, you get it, Isabelle. Woo! Look at that. Okay, took no damage. Yeah, it's true, his defense is a little bit high, but, again, you know, well, we also don't have the ultimate equipment either, so. Aura Blade, really didn't do much last time. Too slow move. It doesn't matter, it's not really an action based system, though. Let's try and burst. Woo! So, yeah, against this guy, magic is definitely your way to go. And be right back. Alright, guys, so that's how you make a boss. And things will be different for you, like, you know, like I said. Or no, I didn't say that yet, did I? Sorry. Things will be different for you if you have changed your classes, and, like, all your stats, if you change your equipment. Things will definitely be different for you. You'll notice a lot of different damages, damage rates, and all that. That being said, I thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you all later.